And now we will learn how to bill the tenants for expenses. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you paid an expense that the tenant is responsible for, it is usually acceptable to bill the tenant for that expense. This means you make the tenant responsible for that particular expense. Well, how do you make them responsible for a particular expense? First, you add the expense to their balance in the tenant's records. And you have to give them an invoice which formally requests payment for that particular expense. Now, what are the steps in billing a tenant? And I'm going to physically demonstrate this in a moment. It's as simple as 1, 2, 3. First, we pay the expense normally with a check, and we make the check the same way we made the check in a prior video. Then we mark the check as billable, and in the prior video, the billable box was already checked automatically, so that should be pretty easy. Just make sure the check mark is there when you save it. Then we put the check on an invoice to the tenant. And that takes 2 seconds. It's very easy. I'm going to show you, and that's all you have to do. It's a breeze. However, before I show you, there's some important things you need to know that happen when you bill a tenant for expenses that you have. When you pay the check, your expense goes up, because you just paid for an expense and QuickBooks records a plus to that particular expense account in your chart of accounts. But when you put the check on an invoice, at that moment, your expense goes down. And that's because at the moment you put the check on an invoice, you are no longer responsible for that payment. That means that you no longer have that expense. Your tenant does, and that's why it gets added to the balance. So be aware that those are the two things that are going to happen after each step. For example, let's imagine on July 20, we paid check number 3 for $150 to Calvin Cleaners for cleaning a spill in apartment 2B where Betty lives. In this example, Betty is responsible, and we're going to mark it as billable to be able to make her pay for it. So, how do we do that? Well, we open the check window just like we did in a previous video, and we scroll forward to July 20. Obviously, we choose the correct tenant, Betty, and the money amount was $150. Let's just double check that. Yep, $150. And of course, to us, it's cleaning expense. But in order to make Betty responsible, we then choose Betty. Now, notice at the moment we choose Betty, it's marked as billable. In this case, we're going to leave the check mark there. At the moment we click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance, and you can see that cleaning expense shows up for the first time as $150. You can also open the profit and loss by tenant, and you can see that we actually do have $150 in cleaning expense for Betty that lowers our profit for apartment 2B. Now, we're going to put that on an invoice. So let's imagine on July 31, we're going to send her the normal monthly rent invoice, but we're going to add to that invoice this check. So, what we do is we click open the invoice and first bring the date forward to July 20, or backward if depending on when you're doing this, to July 20 of 2019. Then, at the moment you choose Betty, this pop-up shows up. And this is a normal pop-up in QuickBooks when you want to bill your tenants for some expense. Leave this selected and then click OK, and this window opens up. Choose billable time and cost. Of course, if we were selling them items or billing them for mileage, these would be the tabs that we choose. But normally we choose the expense tab, and if there were several checks that we wrote as a result of Betty, we would have to choose which ones we're going to add to this invoice. In this example, there's only one, so we click the check mark in the margin and then click OK, and we notice the $150 has been added to this invoice. Then all we have to do is go to the next row and add the normal rent due. And I believe for Betty, the normal rent is $1,000. So $1,000 in rent plus $150 in expenses means that Betty now owes us $1,150 more at the end of July. Click Save and Close. By the way, don't forget to remove the Email Later button, which will pop up even if you don't click it. That will prevent you from saving. So we will click Save and Close. Now, notice cleaning expense has disappeared from the profit and loss by tenant. It is no longer an expense to you. It no longer lowers your profit. Why is that? Because if you go to the tenant balance detail and you look at Betty, you can see she now has an invoice that's not just $1,000, she now has an invoice for $1,050. Now let's just do a quick second example to really drive home the point. Let's imagine on July 25th we paid check number 4 for $100 to Rex for repairs on apartment 3C where Candy lives. Let's imagine that Candy is responsible for this repair and we're going to mark it as billable. So we open the check window and I believe the date was July 25th. So we make the check July 25th. And of course we choose Candy. And the money amount, I believe, was $100. And of course, it's repair expense, the most common expense that tenants cost us. Actually, let's be really careful to make sure that it's only $100. Now, because it's for Candy, we have to go to the bottom right and choose Candy. In this case, leave the billable check mark there because we are going to bill this to Candy. After we click Save and Close, we can open up the Profit and Loss by Tenant, and you can see Candy now has $100 in repair expense, which means we have $100 in repair expense, lowering our profit for apartment 3C. However, on July 26th, we're going to give Candy a specific invoice for this. This means we're not going to add it to the rent for July 31. We're going to bill her separately. Billing her separately will still increase her balance by the amount of the expense. So we can click invoice, and the date of the invoice is July 26th. And look what happens at the moment we click Candy. Aha, she has costs, so we'll click OK. And in this case, it's an expense. It's this particular check. We click here and click OK, and now the $100 has been added. And we can put in the memo any detail that we want explaining why, or you could even type it into the description field, and you might get a little warning message, but you can still do it, and you could describe whatever it was. Make sure the email check mark does not stop you from saving the invoice. When you click Save and Close, look, that money has not, I repeat, is no longer lowering the profit of 3C for Candy because it is now part of Candy's balance. When we look at the tenant balance detail and we scroll down to Candy, we see she now owes us an additional $100, and that's for this specific invoice that we billed her for separately for the repair.